Didn't see you there. I'm here to talk to you about something. Something that's really close and dear to my heart. Now, when we go back in history and we look at some of the great fashion trends that have been around, the 70s gave us bell bottoms, and then so did the 90s. There's a number of things that you can think of. Jean jackets, double denim, back in, just like the TV, pop music, don't you think? Now, I'm going to talk to you about something that really needs to make a proper comeback. That is a man's moustache. It takes a lot of pride, it takes a lot of effort, it takes a lot of grooming, whatever you want to call it, to have one of these bad boys. And I want to talk to you about some of the proudest moustaches that we've seen on our TV screen in the last number of years. And you've just seen some great moustaches, but I'll tell you, it doesn't start scraping the barrel of the great moustaches to come. Now the next three moustaches that I'm going to show you are absolute icons. Icons in the moustache world. Now I may only be a once a month or 1 month a year in the moustache game, but I wear it proudly for that full month. Now, the first moustache that I want to talk to you guys about is our number three moustache. And this man has a news team that needs to be assembled. Here's some of the great moments of Mr. Ron Burghandy.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I please have your attention? I've just been handed an urgent and horrifying news story. And I need all of you to stop what you're doing and listen. Cannonball!
Son of a bee sting, she's turning the entire office against us.
This is grim, real grim. What are we gonna do?
There's only one thing a man can do when he's suffering from a spiritual and existential funk.
Go to the zoo, flip off the monkeys?
No. Buy new suits.
Yay!
Huh. Looking good, you. Looking good. Thanks for joining us, Mr. Ron. Great moustache. Now, the next moustache that I'm going to bring to your attention is one that hasn't really blessed the UK audiences with much authority, but you know, it's one that's just special. It's about a man who takes pride in his moustache like no other person ever has on TV. A man who's taken a picture of every single porterhouse steak he's eaten. A man who builds canoes with his bare hands. A man who tries to cook a pig in the middle of a park. Now, this man is a man's man. A moustache man's man. The manliest of men you could possibly have. This man graced our TV screens in Parks and Recreation. He's a wonderful man, Ron Swanson.
And I'll have the number 8.
That's a party platter. It serves 12 people.
I know what I'm about, son.
Go ahead, Ron.
Okay, let's begin the barbecue.
Oh, hey, little guy. What are you doing?
Oh, no.
Everyone? Meet your meat.
No.
Why are you doing this to us?
Well, in my opinion, not enough people have looked their dinner in the eyes and considered the circle of life.
Hey, Ron, you're not going to slaughter that pig here, are you?
Not to worry. I have a permit.
This just says I can do what I want.
I am the director of the Parks Department, and this is a park.
I couldn't care less about the commendation. But Indianapolis is home to Charles Mulligan's Steakhouse, the best damn steakhouse in the damn state. I have taken a picture of every steak I've ever eaten there. June 2004, porterhouse, medium rare, béarnaise sauce. January 2000, they call this one the Enforcer. February 96, the steak, ribeye. The whiskey, Lagavulin 16. Sorry, everybody. What were we talking about? Recycling? Dentist pulled the tooth out yesterday. But it's always a good idea to demonstrate to your coworkers that you are capable of withstanding a tremendous amount of pain.
Wow. you again. Right, so this last mustache is one that's near and dear to my heart. He's a man known for his quiz show, but had a lot of moments of comedy gold. Now, this man wore a mustache all through the 90s, early 2000s. Recently, he shaved it off. However, a man who dedicates himself to a mustache for that long is a mustache man for life. That's what I always say. Always. Now, this man needs no introduction, unless you're from the UK, because you probably don't know who he is. The famous host of Jeopardy, the late Alex Trebek.
I regrew this. This term for a long-handled gardening tool can also mean an immoral pleasure seeker. Ken.
What's a hoe?
No. Whoa! They teach you that in school in Utah, huh? Al, what's a rake? A rake is right.
I think it's very fun. It's called nerdcore hip-hop. It's
nerdcore hip-hop.
Yes. People who identify as nerdy, rapping about the things they love, video games, science fiction, having a hard time meeting romantic partners, you know. It's really catchy and fun.
Losers, in other words.
Well,
started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Buy a chopper and have a doctor on speed dial, I guess. Mad City. 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch. Young Money Militia, and I am the commissioner. You don't want to start wheezy, because the F is for finisher. Panda, 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 panda. They mad, they ain't famous. They mad, they still nameless. But we still hood famous. Yeah, we still hood famous. I was just getting into this rap thing. I'm not too good at it, but I was getting into it.
For those of you who don't know, we've had some great mustache moments here from three of the best and many others. However, the last one is near and dear to my heart because Alex Trebek recently passed away of prostate cancer. And if you know anything about the Movember Foundation, you know that that's one of the things that they're looking to prevent. And that's one of the focuses. That's where if you donate to this mustache, that's where the money will go. Preventing diseases like prostate cancer, testicular cancer, suicide prevention. And it'll go a long way in helping out. Now, I'm going to leave us with some more mustache gold. Have a great day.
Tonight, Hulk Hogan, what is happening?
Well, you know me, Gene, we really don't know what we're dealing with here, man. And I'm just kind of a little worried about locking up here.
It's all right.
Because we just might blow the whole planet up, you know. Everybody knows that Hulkamania is the strongest force in this universe. But when I hit that ring and I saw what the madness was all about, I realized there was a whole nother universe out there, a whole nother frontier, and the power of the madness and the mania just blew my 24-inch guns out, man.